Yo, what's good everybody, how's it going? My name is Mojo and welcome back to another video. If you are new here, please hit that sub button. I'm kind of new to this, so I'm trying to like point to it, you feel me? I'm just kind of, but yeah, hit that sub button, follow me on Twitter, and I go live on Twitch at @Smojo_YT. So yeah, there you go, three of them right there, hit that guy. So today we're gonna do something different. I have a Def Jade Wizard and I just want to showcase you guys my stats and what I do when I am a Def Jade. Keep in mind, I'm not the best Def Jade out there, you know. I don't have the best stats for a Def Jade Wizard, but my stats aren't half bad, and I just want to share that with you guys, show you guys, and hopefully you get inspired to make a Def Jade wizard. So yeah, here we go. Yeah, here she is. Her name's Tatiana, and this is in a new update. So, you know, I got the cool looking eyes, you feel me? They're green with the black, you know, everything look fine. You know, she all matchy, you feel me? She looking cool, she looking good. You know, I'm about to take that screen. Hold on real quick. Let me take that. Snap that guy right quick. But yeah, this is my Def Jade Wizard. At the moment, my stats are I'm 85 resistance to everything, and I have immunity to four different classes. I get this done, as you guys know, with Jade gear, the ring and everything. So I'm just gonna go down everything that I have, from hat all the way down to my deck, the cards that I use, and why I use these things. So we're using the Jade Hood of Mystery, level 110. I 100% forgot what pack this came in, but you can just Google it and figure out what pack to get it out of. It is a pack item. Most of these items that I am using, as for the gear and everything, cost money, which is the only downside. But yeah, you get what you pay for, I suppose. But yeah, so we're using the Jade Hood of Mystery, the number one best resistance hood in the game, I believe. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think it is the number one best. Secondly, we're using the Spooky Carnival Suit. You can either use this or you can also use the Jade Robe. The Jade Robe gives, I believe, 2% more universal resistance. But the upside of the Spooky Carnival Suit is you get an AoE spell that's called Kiss of Death. It's a death spell, and it's basically like the sacrifice spell where you hit yourself for 250, you heal for 700. This is exactly the same, except you hit yourself for 1000, you can't use resistance, and you're going to give 750 health to everybody in the team, which is still a really good card. Even if you can't use resistance, usually when I use this spell, I heal myself for like 2k. So I mean, I'm taking 1k and I'm healing everybody in my team for like 2k plus. So it's a good sacrifice. So we're using that. Another reason why this is better than the Jade Robe is because it gives a lot more health. I'm not sure how much the Jade Robe gives, but I know that this gives a lot more health than the Jade Robe, and it also gives a lot of outgoing. I'm not sure if the Jade Robe gives any Shadow Pip rating. I was gonna say percentage, but rating, I still don't understand that. I don't. But yeah, so yeah, overall this is a lot better. Now when if you're a life wizard, I would recommend going for the Jade Robe, because you're not going to be using the spell at all, so it's not as beneficial to you, you know. So I would definitely just go for the Jade Robe. But for death wizards, this is the way to go, and this robe costs $30. It's a bundle robe only that costs $30. You get this, you get the hat, wand, boots, and you get the mount. Now the mount is a 4-person mount, which is a 50% speed, which is arguably the best mount in the game, one of the best mounts in the game, and you get the one of the best robes in the game. Other than that, the rest of it is just stitch gear, and the stats aren't all that great. But yeah, so we're rocking this. For our boots, we're using the Jade boots. We could use the Rockstar kicks, I believe. They give, I think they're 18% resistance. I'm not 100% sure. But the reason why we use these is because they also give outgoing. I don't think the Rockstar boots give any outgoing. But yeah, so we're using the Jade boots. For our wand, we're using Root of Spring. We could use the wand that also comes with the Jade set, but the reason why I like to use this one is because of the May Cast. The May Cast doesn't work all the time, but it's a pretty good chance that it will work. I'd say it's around 80, 85, maybe even 90% of the chance it will work. And that's really good for a wand. It May Cast this. I mean, it May Cast the Rebirth, and it gives you two cards, 30% healing for everybody, which is really, really good. Usually when I use this spell, I heal my entire team for 1200 to 1500 health, which is phenomenal for only a 2-pip spell, you know. For our anthem, we are using the Heartsteel anthem. 5% universal resistance, so it's really good. Probably, I think it is the best anthem that you can use for JD. Yeah, I believe so. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure I'm right on that one. For our anthem, we're using a 5% anthem. There is a better one that drops from Rat Spin. It gives 6% universal resistance. I'm just too lazy to farm him to get it. And yeah, I mean, 1% resistance off isn't really all that bad. That's why I said that I don't have the best stats, but like, I'm pretty far up there, you feel me? For the ring, I've crafted every resistance ring out there, so I could pretty much use any of these, depending on the boss that I'm going after or whatnot. So I can use any of those. To craft them, I honestly forgot, you know. I might put it down in the description, like a link on how to, you know, I'm gonna put down in the description a link on where to find these rings, how to craft them, and everything like that. I might even make a video on it, who knows. But yeah, these are very, very vital. There is a universal resistance ring, not sure how much it is, not sure how to get it. I just know it's out there, but I personally prefer these rings because I can specify which class that I want to increase my resistance of. For my pet, I'm using an old ward pet. Not the best ward pet. I really want to go for Storm Ice. I have a lot of ward pets in here, actually. But most of them were fails. And this is the only one that actually got all the way up to Mega. The next one I think that I'm going to get is this one. I'm hoping that this guy doesn't fail once it reaches Mega. And it's looking a lot better for the Storm Resistance and Ice Resistance. If I get Fire on that guy, I'll be very, very happy. But yeah, so for my resistance pet, I'm using this one. I also switch it up only when I'm going against a storm boss. At the moment, I'm trying to make a all ward pet for storm because I figure that the only time that I actually use my immunity during a boss battle is during Corporal Tennis, and he's a storm boss. And right now, this one is giving me what, 35% universal resistance? I mean, 35% resistance to storm. So I majority of the time use this when I'm going against him. And I use, like, you know, the storm ring. I have 125, you know, resistance and everything. It's a whole thing. So that's basically my gear and my stats. I mean, the mount doesn't really matter. My deck, I'm using this one, which I don't really know why. If I'm being honest, it's just a deck to use. Yeah. And for my spells, I'm usually let me take these out. This is for a boss that I was doing. But yeah, usually I just go for juju. Bad juju all the way. Just juju. Your main thing being a death wizard, you really, really want to juju, because that's like your thing, you know. You're everybody knows you for the jujuer and a virtual plaguer, you know. Juju, virtual plague, empowers, and that's it. You can also rock the shadow sentinel on top of that, because you know it's mainly for tanks anyways, but usually that's pretty much it. I also keep my pet cards in there along with the wand spells, just because, you know, you never know when you're gonna need them, right? You never know. But yeah, this is basically my setup right here. That was pretty quick and easy. But yeah, if you guys want to be a death jade wizard, here you go. Here's the gear to go for. Here's the stats that you're gonna have. And yeah, other than that, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. I will be making another video on a jade healer. So it's gonna be a little bit less resistance, but it's gonna be more on the healing side of things, you know, because right now this setup gives me 42% outgoing, and my jade healing setup gives me over 100 outgoing. But I don't have that much resistance. It'll be an upcoming video. I don't want to spoil it too much. Not too much. But yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, comment, subscription. If you guys have any setups that you want to share, leave them down in the comments below, or join the Discord and just share them. And yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed. Have a great day, and I'm out. Peace.